No. I thought I was done with these. When did they even make a third Smurfs movie? I've never heard of this. Well, granted, there were Smurfs movies prior to the 2010s, but let's face it, those two movies that Sony produced were not good in the slightest. They were products of their time, which is saying a lot because that time was only a couple years ago. That's how bad they've already aged. But this one didn't bring back Roger Gosnell. Instead, we have Kelly Asbury, who was one of the directors of Shrek 2. So that alone kind of piques my interest, but I don't know. Third time's the charm, I guess? Let's pop it in and find out what happens.
So the immediate thing that should be noticed here is that this Smurfs movie is completely animated and doesn't seem to have any connections to the previous entries. It's a reboot of the franchise, which, from a critical standpoint, makes a lot of sense. Not that I'm at all knowledgeable about the Smurfs franchise, but any person who has an idea of what the Smurfs are would understand that the Roger Gosnell movies completely disregard what the characters, style, and humor should be. The first thing Smurfs The Lost Village accomplishes is hitting exactly the right tone needed for a franchise like this. The colors are bright, the characters are goofy and have personality, which you think would be pretty easy since the personality is associated with their names, but as the two other movies proved, even this can be done wrong. Here, the characters are recast with even better voice actors, even if they're still portrayed by famous people. They seem to suit each individual Smurf better than the last two. This time, Smurfette is captured by the evil Gargamel, but when the other Smurfs save her, they discover that there's a lost village beyond the Forbidden Forest, which may be the home to long-forgotten Smurfs. The plot is eerily similar to the second movie, which was also about Smurfette being captured and finding similar Smurf-like creatures, but this time around, the new Smurfs are all women, which helps Smurfette to feel more comfortable than ever before. Can they work together to defeat Gargamel by the end? Are all these movies slowly starting to sound like the same thing over and over again? That's probably the most disappointing part of this film. I was really excited that they got rid of the live-action characters, kept the focus on the Smurfs, and had a lot of fun with the animation, including the introduction of female Smurfs, since that has always been lacking in the past, and the new characters all have their own personalities and make the second act more interesting. The only problem is, I don't really see many new things being done this time around. Having already seen the last two movies' plotlines and knowing the themes of the Smurfs comics and TV show, it doesn't really offer anything that hasn't previously been seen before. There's a few good jokes here and there. There's a Smurf that the narrator calls table-eating Smurf, which is just great. In fact, the narrator plays with quite a few scenes. Gargamel and Azrael manage to be more silly this time around, and since they're animated, their antics feel more in tone. They introduce this bird character who's a complete klutz and delivers some pretty great slapstick. And the new cast really nails their characters down, making the banter enjoyable enough, even if it's overdone. I suppose it should be commended for containing almost no potty humor and not having some random romantic connection between characters. The animation is really pleasant, and the designs of the creatures and plants are really outside the box at times. The speed is also on point, taking notes from previous work on Hotel Transylvania and Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. I just wish the story would have taken more chances, or would have been a little wackier or bigger. I think this really could have been a definitive take on the Smurfs and paid tribute in the ultimate way, but instead it plays it as another safe adventure with a few funny jokes and a bad ending that's been done before in the likes of Care Bears 2 and the first Pokemon movie. They also introduce this plot device where Smurfette can apparently absorb the powers of those who attack her, or something like that. They don't really explain it too well. It makes sense in the movie, but it was obviously inserted to have a quick fix for the climax. So while it has its moments and is a good representation of the Smurfs, I don't find The Lost Village to be particularly memorable. It's a much better movie to show your kids than the last two, but even then, I make that comparison lightly, because while I dislike the last two flicks, I don't think they're quite as awful as the whole world made them out to be. Plus, they were still pretty successful, and The Lost Village actually made even less money. So I guess people really want the live-action characters in it, which is a conversation all unto itself. For now, this is the best Sony Animation-produced Smurfs movie, and I don't see the series continuing anytime soon. It's also the best Sony Animation release of 2017 so far, easily beating the awful Surf's Up 2. And we still have two more 2017 movies to go. Which one is next?
Again, I have to watch this movie again!
Thanks to Ryan for this Patreon request. And thanks to all my Patreon supporters. For only $7, you can get your own monthly movie review. Ask me to review anything I haven't already. There's also other perks like blogs, exclusive videos, and early access. You can also follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And thanks so much for watching this video.